So we can disagree.
We can?
We can, and we do occasionally, but should we be calling each other evil? Should we call our fellow Americans evil? President Trump does that a lot, more than past presidents. Are there consequences to that rhetoric? John Avlon has our answer in his reality check. Hello, John.
Hello, Allie. So look, in the wake of the Barr memo summarizing the Mueller report, President Trump is turning the rhetoric up to 11. And is even resorting to using a four-letter word.
Evil things, very bad things, I would say treasonous things, many of them, you know who they are. They've done so many evil things.
Trump then threatened these alleged evildoers, saying they would be, quote, looked at. So let's talk about evil in the very different way presidents use the word. These are primarily described things like terrorism, mass shootings, and the Holocaust. George W. Bush used it constantly after 9/11.
It stood in defiance of evil. Either you support evil or you support good. An act of kindness in the face of evil.
In fact, Bush used the term at more than 400 events during his presidency. Here's a scroll to give you a sense of the sheer tonnage of it. But again, most often it described foreign terrorists, their ideologies, and their acts. President Obama used the word evil a lot less, about 90 times, from his Nobel Peace Prize speech to the last time he spoke to the press.
I think there's evil in the world, but I think that at the end of the day, if we work hard, the world gets a little better each time.
But with the rise of Donald Trump, the word evil is making a comeback. In 2 years, he's almost matched Obama's mention of evil in two terms. And yes, much of the time he's condemned actually evil things, like terrorism, the Holocaust, and sex trafficking. But that's why President Trump's repeated descriptions of his political opponents as evil is so noteworthy, and why it should be nothing that we normalize. Take a listen.
These are very, very bad and evil people.
That Washington, D.C., it got a lot of evil there. A lot of evil. A lot of bad people.
He called John McCain's handover of the Steele dossier to the FBI evil and hit Democrats with the same term.
Some very evil people. Some of them are Democrats, I must say.
When Brett Kavanaugh was accused of a high school sexual assault, it was the accusers who were evil.
It was a disgraceful situation brought about by people that are evil.
Of course, he's railed against journalists as evil, from calling the New York Times, quote, so evil and so bad, to his favorite term, fake news, and how evil it can be, now echoed by autocrats around the globe. Look, this should concern all Americans, because tone comes from the top. And here's some troubling evidence of its effect. A recent study found that more than 40% of people in both parties believe the opposition isn't just wrong, they're, quote, downright evil. Think about that for a second. This ratcheting up of rhetoric has a real cost to our country because democracy depends upon an assumption of goodwill between fellow citizens, even and especially those who disagree. That's why Trump's threat to look into these alleged evil people behind the Mueller report is so dangerous. Trump's bluster is being amplified by allies in Congress and in conservative media, where phrases like investigate the investigators are being repeatedly blasted on Fox News. We're in danger of defining deviancy down and setting up an election where both sides are calling for the imprisonment of their political opponents. This is more suited to a banana republic than the United States of America. And that's your reality check.
Yes, it would be helpful to expand the vocabulary of insults so that we can just move away from the evil one. John, well, thank you.
Words matter. I mean, words matter. Absolutely matter. And I think it's great that you pointed out how people have used that word in the past compared to how it's being used now, John. Thank you for that.